Federal Attorney General Office said today that there are organized groups with strong support. He did not specify the kind of support behind the violence in parts of Amir and Benchingal regional states, western Ethiopia. Zenaba Chunan, Public Relation and Communications Director in the office, Eskinder Firu, in Addis Ababa did not name names in connection with the political identities of what he called groups behind the violence. Findings of the task force that the Attorney General Office deployed to the region this week to establish identities of groups or individuals to be held responsible for killings will be made public, Zenaba added. The Attorney General Office is convinced, based on Zenaba's response, that the violence in the above-mentioned areas is not haphazard. Rather, it is a planned one and carried out in a coordinated manner. Asked if the Office of the Attorney General would agree with statement from the National Security Council, came out this week, which clearly stated that groups behind the violence are those who lost power and privilege due to ongoing change in the country, the Public Relation and Communications Director of the Attorney General Office said that he cannot tell about it now as the findings will be made public when they are finalized. US-based Ethiopian satellite television, on the other hand, cited Benchingal regional state authorities to report yesterday that the radical ethno-nationalist group in Omo region, Omo Liberation Front OLF, is behind the violence. OLF itself, however, issued a statement condemning the incident that claimed the lives of several members of the regional police and civilians as well, which some analysts say is a political cover. A renewed protest is unfolding across Omo regional state, and protesters seem to have mixed messages, probably by design. On the one hand, they're calling upon the federal government to act decisively against the killings and displacement of civilians. On the other hand, there is a loosely expressed campaign against leaders of Omo Democratic Party, including Prime Minister Abiy Ahmed, which is the main power player in the region credited for ending TPLF's ruthless rule from within the ruling coalition by forging a political alliance with what is now Amara Democratic Party ADP, another member of the ruling coalition. Unlike the radical group, ODP envisions the creation of a democratic Ethiopia and is forming alliances with other moderate ethnic Omo political organizations. Last week, it reached agreement to Omo Democratic Front ODF, whose leaders are among the pioneer Omo ethno-nationalists and founders of OLF, who later quit with the organization. As far as Ethiopian government action is concerned, in accordance with decision of the National Security Council, which is the highest collective authority in the country on matters related to peace and security, the federal government deployed forces to the regions that were affected by the violence last week, and over 200 suspects allegedly involved in the killings of civilians and policemen are arrested. Meanwhile, Omiya Regional State Cabinet held a meeting today to discuss current affairs, including security and peace situation in the region. And the cabinet fully supported the decision of the National Security Council, according to a report by Fana Broadcasting Corporation.